It's Tinla here, and welcome to another episode of GoPro Settings. Today, I want to investigate what GoPro White Balance settings I should be using for the night skiing. For daytime skiing, such as this, when it is cloudy, as you see here, it is okay to use the Auto White Balance because GoPro is pretty good at adjusting the correct color temperature of the pixels. But the Auto White Balance has its own issues, so make sure you watch until the end of this video. I'll let you know why I don't like to use the Auto White Balance for night skiing. So I got out to the local parking lot, which has a very similar LED lighting conditions as most skiing resorts at nighttime. So here's the 2300K, which appears to be very blue. The cyan color dominate the midtone of the scene, so I don't think I'll be using the 2300K for my white balance settings. Everything appears to be blue and green, which is the cyan color of the whole scene. Moving up to the 4500K, it is almost perfect, but as you can see, the highlight and the midtones have the red and yellow tint to it, and it is shown in the waveform RGB scope on the upper right corner. The shadow, which is the night sky, has a red tint to it, which I remember correctly that the night sky is indeed has a red tint. Okay, moving up to the next color temperature, which is the 5000K. Still not that bad, but it starts to show the yellowish look, the warmer look, I should say, to the scene, as confirmed by the waveform RGB. The night sky appears to be reddish, which I think is about right as well. It's not too much red, but it still appears to be red. In order to understand the waveform RGB scope, you need to take a look at the gray rectangular with 5000 white letter fonts. On the scope, you would see the 50% gray, the middle line at the 50 line mark, and then 100%, which is the white color of the font. That's how it is, okay? At the highest setting for the white balance, which is the 6500K, now it is completely warm. Everything appears to be yellow and reddish for this lighting conditions. As with 2300K, I won't be using this color settings for my night skiing. Next on the list is the native white balance. A lot of people don't like to use the native white balance of the GoPro camera due to the fact that it appears to be warm, as it is confirmed on the waveform RGB scope. The highlight has some yellow tint to it, but compared to the 4500K and the 5000K color temperature, the shadow appears to be less saturated, which preserves all the details on the shadow. Another reason that people don't like to use is that you have to do a color corrections process in post with the native white balance. So it added another step. If you do a quick capture, native white balance might not be your, you know, your go-to settings. But after I do some color correction to the native white balance, as you can see here, everything appears to be correct. White snow is white, and red night sky color is less saturated compared to the 4500K or the 5000K settings. By doing this in post, you have more room to play with the color temperature of your footage, whether you want to express to be warmer look or the cold look of the winter night. You'll be able to do that more effectively with the native white balance than any other white balance settings of the GoPro. Okay, here's the famous auto white balance from the GoPro camera. It appears almost like how I do color correction to my native white balance. The white snow is white and the night sky color is reddish, kind of look to the night sky. Pretty much the same how I did to the native white balance in post. But it has a limitation, okay? If you're walking from one lighting conditions to the next lighting conditions, things will change and it will change the color of the night sky into something else different than the red tint, which is incorrect. Because the night sky to my eyes, they remain the same reddish color look to the night sky. But as you can see here, I'm walking through this different lighting conditions. The night sky appears to be bluish color, which is strange. Yeah, you can do some color correcting in post for the auto white balance. Basically, it will be the same as native white balance. You have to do color correcting anyways, right? This is the limit of the auto white balance. As long as you understand the limitation of the auto white balance, you should be good to use it. If you're afraid of throwing off the color of your footage, use the auto white balance, okay? So it will save you a lot of time, but then again, understand the limitation of the auto white balance of the GoPro cameras, just in case, you know? Okay, so at the end of this video, I would stick to the 4500K white balance settings if I want to have a colder look, or the 5000K setting if I want to have a warmer look to my footage. If I want to have more control of the color in post, I would go for the native white balance. I won't use the auto white balance. I would use it for a certain time only to capture the color information and use my native white balance later on in post to correct the color according to the auto white balance at the calibrated scene. Hey, that's it for this video, and I hope you liked the videos, and if you like it, please give a like because it's really helped me out with the channel and the YouTube algorithm. So I really appreciate it, and bye for now, and hopefully I'll see you in the next video, okay?